welcome to the show. Good evening, good morning, good afternoon, no matter where you are in this fine land of ours, no matter what time it is that you're listening to it, we want you to know how pleased, how delighted, how absolutely tickled we are that you've taken time out of your schedule to join us today. My name is Daryl Prale, and I'm going to be your host tonight as we talk about creating your performing arts education with Algonquin College. I got to tell you, I got a room full of women here, folks, and they're all smiling and they're anxious to do this. These are performers. I can tell you, you should see Chelsea sitting here. She's got a wonderful wardrobe going on, full of polka dots. Catherine is smiling galore. I see the mischief in her eyes. I can tell you that. And Diane is here to hopefully hold the whole room together. So with that, let's get this show on the road. We're here to talk about your future. And to do that, it's a two-way conversation. Part of that is we're going to give you the lowdown, the heads up on the program, and we're going to give you lots of details about it. We're going to preempt some of your questions. You know, what's it like? What's the faculty? What's involved? How long does it last? What do I need? And at the same time, we're going to actually have you folks send us any questions you have. You can ask a generic question. You can say, hey, Chelsea. You can say, hey, Kath. Hey, Diane. What do you want to know? You do that, but to do that, you have to know how. The answer is pretty straightforward. You use the control panel, and that's in your upper right-hand corner of your screen, and you see that, and you just go to your question, you type it in. We'll get it in real time. We will share it with our panelists, and once we're through the core content, we will then tackle every single one of your questions. So the core content is going to take about 30 minutes, just so you know, so you can schedule your night. We're going to have you out of here no later than an hour from now, often earlier. One final way, if you're a social media maven and you want to send your questions via Twitter, you can do that as well. Just make sure you reference at AC Design School, like you see at the bottom of your screen there, and we will get it that way as well. We get lots of questions, as you might ask, anticipate. One of them being, is this being recorded? And the answer there, of course, is it is being recorded. Second question is, great, can I get a copy of it? And the answer is, you absolutely will. In a handful of days, if you've registered, you will receive an email, and in it will have a link. If, for whatever reason, you don't get that email, it goes to your spam folder, whatever it might be, just go to the website where the actual program is overviewed, and you're going to have that link at the end of the show here, so don't have to worry about it. And you will see there in that section this webinar, so you can watch it. Best of all, what we encourage you to do is share the webinar on social media. Go to your Facebook, your LinkedIn, your Twitter, because if you have an interest in this, you can be darn sure that lots of friends and peers and others do as well. So maybe they didn't get the invite. Now it's your chance to do your good deed for the day. I mentioned my name is Daryl Prale. I'm your host. That's enough about me. Let's get to the real people. Catherine. So Kath, as we like to call her, has been teaching at the college for 25 years in a variety of programs in the Faculty of Arts, Media, and Design, and was responsible for creating the Theater Arts program. Kath is a mentor, creative artist, director, singer, actor, comedian, improv artist, and I'm told she used to play a mean trumpet. She is also thankful for her training with the National Arts Center Student Young Company. You have her email address there in front of her, folks, if you want to email her any specific questions. You'll see that again later on in the show. Kath, welcome to the show.
Thank you. Happy Woo! To be here.
She's excited. All right. Next up is Chelsea. All right. Chelsea O'Connor is an award-winning producer, entertainer, television host, writer, voice actor, singer-songwriter, comedian, jeweler, painter, and user experience designer. Talk about artistic. Holy smokes. Shifting into a new gear in the entertainment business for consumers, she is currently the CEO and co-founder of Dive Communications, Inc., working with a team of mobile technology professionals developing video communications products. She is also serving as chair of the advisory committee for Algonquin College's new performing arts program. Chelsea is also an alumni of the Algonquin College Television Broadcasting Program, as well as an alumni of Ryerson University. With a Bachelor of Fine Arts in Acting, she is well-schooled, well-practiced, and an entrepreneur, and I swear she looks like she's 19 years old. So, Chelsea, welcome to the show.
Thank you so much. Happy to be here.
Bringing us out is Diane. She's the one that's going to keep us in line. She has all the answers for whatever Kat and Chelsea can't tell us. She is a results-driven marketing communications specialist with 28-plus years in the media and design industries. She has vast experience in directing and implementing a broad range of marketing, communications, project management, and branding activities from concept to completion. She excels in helping prospective students find a program in the School of Media and Design that they are passionate about and matches their talents. This is the woman you want if you have questions. Diane, welcome to the show.
It's a pleasure to be here, Daryl.
All right, so who wants to take this question? I just want to kind of set it out here. I'm going to throw it over to you, Kath. The question is very straightforward. For our audience that's listening right now, just set the framework. What is the Performing Arts Program? How does it work?
Performing Arts Program is a one-year Ontario College certificate program. It is absolutely geared toward emerging artists. We work with you, we explore with you, we determine where you want to go, what next steps you want to take into the industry or further education. We have a completely hands-on approach. We train students in voice, movement, spoken word, comedy, theater, music, any performance-related area. We're looking at stilters, puppeteers. We have no idea other than we want to work with artists. You will work with other artists in the program and create art.
Wow. I'm excited already. So talk to me, how long is the program?
The program is 1 year certificate. That means that you have 2 15-week semesters. So it starts in September and ends the end of April.
All right, now how many students do you, now this is actually, maybe actually back it up. This is a new program, is that right?
It's a brand new program.
So what was, I'll ask the question, what was the catalyst for the program?
The catalyst for the program was industry. Industry said that we needed people who could be trained in performance, but not necessarily specific to just theater. So there's no training at this period of time for a singer other than private training or the University of Ottawa, which does great training, but a lot of people just want a one-year thing. Could I just have a one-year thing and determine whether or not this is really what I want to do for the rest of my life? There's absolutely no training for spoken word in the city. There's no training for comedy in the city. So industry approached, and we responded to industry.
That's fantastic. Now, Chelsea, you're the advisor, right? You're chair of the advisory program for this, mm-hmm. Is that right? So talk to me about the discussions and actually putting this content together. You know, was it, did you actually have a lot of laughs, I would think, as a background?
I think we had a lot of, laughs and definitely realizations about, you know, the realities of the industry and, you know, creating this program with the demands that are out there for not only emerging artists, but existing artists to have more than one skill set, and certainly to come from you know, a base skill set that can extend itself to any form of art. So I think it was really insightful of, you know, Kath and Algonquin College to offer this program, because it really does speak to the realities of being an artist these days, with the inception of all the, you know, digital programs that are out there, all the, you know, social media and sharing platforms that you can create content and share your art with other people, that, you know, there's a bigger market for a lot of different forms of art now. And so offering, you know, an education program that speaks to that need, or even that exposure, it's pretty amazing.
Now, Diane, talk to me about the program, because, you know, as the faculty marketing officer, how do you see it differentiating from the other programs, and what's unique about it?
Well, one of the things that to me really sells this program is one of our main goals is to help you prepare for an audition. And if you want to go on in your career, either to university, at Algonquin, or another college or post-secondary institution, you are likely required to do an audition in order to get accepted into a program. So that was another huge decision in us choosing to start this program, is because there aren't a lot of other preparatory programs are out there that help students prepare for an audition.
Excellent call, without a doubt. I think one of the wonderful things about the program is that we do live and digital theater. So in first semester, it's live performance. We get you on the boards right away. We get you confidence in your artistic ability, including audition techniques. Second semester is live and digital. You'll learn how to upload your incredible performances to the web, whatever format you wish. It really allows you to gain confidence to build a number of different auditions. You don't want to walk out with just one. You want to walk out with a number of them. If you're multi-talented, if you're a singer and you love to act and you love to do monologues, what a wonderful program. One week you can do a song, the next week you can do a monologue, and we can work on that with you. So we look at multiple areas of performance and support you in any area you wish to go.
And definitely that flexibility is required, certainly in the, you know, the professional field. But also, you know, speaking to audition prep, as a performer, you audition for everything that you do. So that is one of the core elements of being a performer, no matter what performance arts you are in. And also certainly if you end up pursuing, you know, additional education beyond the program, doing a self-made audition is a requirement in most professional performance programs. So that includes the ability to create your own material and perform it for a panel of judges. So this, in many ways, is very applicable to the real world and provides a solid foundation for anybody that wants to pursue performing arts.
So let me ask this question, then we'll go on to the next slide, which is, you know, and I'll just look at you maybe more specifically, Chelsea. You know, so as a graduate of the radio program, as well as, you know,
television.
Sorry, thank you. Television program.
Yes.
That's right. And then, of course, your degree from Ryerson in the acting. If I'm looking at this program versus any other variety of programs, what would make me decide that this program is the one that's right for me right now at my point in my life?
I think I'll toss that over to Kath.
Oh, thanks a lot.
Yeah, no problem.
Thank you. This program is geared toward people who really want to fine-tune their skills, fine-tune their audition abilities. Also exploratory. Where do I want to go? There might be a university graduate out there who never got launched into the industry. They didn't feel the confidence that they required. This true hands-on approach will give that person that confidence. A lot of schools tend to sort of break people down and mold them into the way that they believe they think is best. I believe the opposite. I believe that an artist needs to be empowered. An artist needs to be listened to, valued, and given the skills and confidence to get where they need to go. We also have a course called Achieving Success. In that course, we'll actually examine where you can go from here. So I'm in a one-year program. I'm learning to do all the things that I love. I'm learning to get the tools. I'm acquiring the tools that I can, for example, if I want to audition for something in another city, I can send them my CD. I can send them, it can be uploaded to the web. They can see it. I can send them a link to it. But what this program really does is allow you the confidence to get your feet up and out. Maybe you've auditioned to a theater school before or a different kind of performance school and didn't make it. This is the time where you can really spend and perfect your art and next time walk in knowing I have the ability to do this and I'm going to do it in an incredibly wonderful way because I know I can. I have proof. I've even created a digital proof of that.
I love what you're saying. And I mean, this, and what I even love is the point here on this slide. In all of that, in that safe environment, the ability to grow and develop and work with my peers, I'm also benefiting from the whole experience of being in that college environment. So I get to jump right in, you know, grow, expand my wings, and be inspired by my classmates.
Without a doubt.
Without a doubt. That's
without
phenomenal.
A doubt. We even have courses in creativity and ensemble. And in ensemble, all students will work together and create works of art.
You also talk about the fact that, I think both of you have talked about the fact, Chelsea and Kath, that you may want to grow on to other programs, right? So when you're in that college environment, now you can actually go talk to the folks in television or in radio or any other creative facet and really, you know, instead of just listening to this webinar or reading what's online or what maybe a high school counselor might say, you get to go and actually say, what's it like?
You'll have the The coordinators come into the program. They're my colleagues. They've offered to come in and really speak to the students and tell them exactly what their programs are like, whether or not it's really geared to that person. Sometimes you have a dream, and then you get there and go, wow, this isn't anything like what I was looking for. But if you have exposure to it beforehand, that's awesome. We have the radio program that's willing to have us work with their incredible state-of-the-art equipment.
Yeah.
Just because the guy's awesome, and he's like, bring your students in. We want them to practice here. We want them to get a real life world experience. And Algonquin's the place to get that. We've got professional TV studios, professional radio studios, professional music industry studios, and I would say the most amazing faculty you would ever want to work with.
We're going to come back to your faculty in a minute. I actually want to ask you some questions on that. But, you know, I'm sure the people listening to that, you know, that answer, what you just gave, are like chomping at the bit to say, how do I apply? We're going to get there, folks. But you also may have other questions, because as I listen to this, you know, my mind just keeps on going, well, what about this? What about that? If you have a question, let me remind you, you can go on Twitter, at AC Design School. You can also go to the control panel and just type your question in there. And both Kath and Chelsea and Diane would love to offer you their unique perspective from their vantage and their involvement in the program. So you get multiple perspectives, which is phenomenal, all in real time. Talk to me about the curriculum. You talked to me a little bit about it. I look at vocal techniques, and the way I started today's webinar, I could definitely use some vocal technique help.
But you're already enrolled.
Yeah.
Good to go.
Yeah. We registered as soon as we heard that. You know,
you're just confidence.
Exactly.
That's all.
Oh my! So if you're listening and you can relate to my little faux pas there at the beginning, then I'll see you in class. I love this. So you actually go in depth with on-camera techniques in addition to stage presence. That is huge. Now, how do you do that? Maybe just share a little bit.
We have courses in it, so we've got a course in voice. We've got a course in live and digital production. We have performance classes as well, so you'll have a live performance class, and we'll actually in our live performance follow up course look at digital performance as well. So we'll teach you how to do voice in radio, so just voiceovers. And we'll also teach you how to develop an authentic and quality on-camera performance as well.
That's huge. And it's funny. I mean, I know we're talking a lot about performing, but Chelsea, you also said something early on, especially with your new role as CEO of Dive Communications. Mm-hmm. One of the biggest things I see as a professional marketer is getting people who are skilled to be, whether it's, you know, shall we say, YouTube ready, you know, content, mm-hmm. you know, podcast capable, because a lot of the business side needs those artistic, creative skills to produce the content to promote their products and their services. And it is sorely lacking. So when I look at something like this, just as a potential employer, this gets me thrilled.
Yeah. Who would have known when I graduated, and we don't really need to say that year, who would have known that there would be web series.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Who would have known that? We would never would have known that. We have no idea where our students are going to be going, not only in terms of the technologies they might use, but physically where we'll go. Could be working in Korea. You have absolutely no idea. And this course is about really opening you up and letting you see the potential.
All right.
And I think, you know, what you were saying is, you know, having a creative edge. Anybody can push buttons, but do you mm-hmm. have that creative edge? Do you have that voice within you that, you know, that gives you your own edge in the business space? I mean, if you asked me 10 years ago whether or not I would be CEO of a communications company, I would have said, are you kidding me?
Yeah.
I mean, awesome, but I never dreamed of it. But knowing who I was as a performer, knowing who I was as an artist is what has led me to where I am now. So I think, you know, with a combination of confidence, creativity, and also a little bit of entrepreneur, that, you know, students that start in this program can have a better opportunity to, you know, understand who they are in their next step for their career.
It's so true. I know, you know, the classic stereotype is if you want to do a business program versus a performing arts aspect. You know, you always needed the MBA. But bluntly, in today's world, in my experience, you need this as much as you need that. They really go together.
Absolutely.
That's just the way it is.
Yeah.
All right.
I would say the other thing about the program, specifically in our ensemble course, is that you learn how to work with other people. If you ask any employer today,
huge,
they will tell you they can train the skill. They can't reskill a person. So they're really hiring for the human skills a person brings. They're hiring a person, not just a skill. And when you can learn to work in an artistic environment with other people well, you've got a wonderful career ahead of you.
Awesome. And also when you get to know who you are as an artist,
yes,
to begin with, you know, a real reality of the industry is dealing with rejection. And that's a heck of a lot easier when you know who you are and how to bounce back from those rejections. And I mean, rejection is often used as a negative word, but really in this industry, if you can turn it into a positive, then you have such a great chance at an amazing career, no matter what you do, if you know who you are and what kind of performer you are.
You can just hear the smile in Chelsea's voice as she's excited to talk about it. And it's so true, yeah, what you're saying. Now, Kath, you were adamant and passionate at the same time a moment ago about the quality of the faculty. So help me understand, you know, where does that conviction come from? Like in the sense of, talk to me about the faculty, because they've clearly made an impression upon you.
Oh, without a doubt. And I was speaking specifically to the programs that a lot of the students here may choose to go on to, and that would be radio, TV broadcasting, and music, arts industries.
Mm-hmm.
I've had the privilege of working with my colleagues for a number of years, and they are so incredibly passionate in their disciplines, but truly invested in their students. They have incredible connections with clients. They take their students out into their environment day one. They've got cameras around the campus, or semester one, they produce their own radio show. They are really about the experiential learning and really about getting every individual to where they need to get in order to get into industry.
And I've also, like, can speak from experience through going through university and then college.
Yep.
You know, the experience as, you know, in a creative program, the difference between, you know, sort of a more academic, theoretical education versus a hands-on education.
Yeah.
Ryerson was, it was a theater school, so I did have a lot of practical in-studio experience there, but with the combination of the theoretical, it was a pretty heavy load. And then when I found with my college experience, learning hands-on was so different, and it was for me, you know? It really depends on who you are, what kind of education you want. But I know, and I know a lot of my friends who are also performers, are very hands-on people. So I really related with my hands-on education more so than my academic approach to education.
That's phenomenal. One of the things, you know, we've done a number of these webinars for a variety of the programs, including, you know, radio and journalism and everything else. And we hear over and over again, to your point, Chelsea, about the academic versus the hands-on, that the professors really do come alongside the students and really not only teach them, but I don't want to say mentor them or coach them, but that's almost probably the right word. There very much is a much more one-on-one relationship. Without a doubt.
Someone once asked me, what if you were really shy and have no experience as a singer and no music background? You don't need that. We're going to take you from wherever you are right here, and we will exactly do that. Mentor, empower, work with one-on-one. The students all get that experience at the college because faculty know that our students, when they graduate, they represent what we teach. They go out into industry, and we want them to be absolutely their best because it's a reflection on what we do every day as well. We want our students to be stellars. We want them to be stars, and we work really hard at ensuring that they have the tools and skills to do that.
Another thing that I'd like to add to that, for those who are listening that may not be familiar with the way college works, is that everybody who teaches at college has actually worked in the industry they're teaching. They're not academics per se, not to say that they're not all brilliant. And the way it works is, Kath was talking about the TV, the radio, and the music programs that we have at Algonquin. Every one of those coordinators still works in the industry. So they work full-time, and on weekends they still do things, or when they have their summers off. So they totally get it. They're totally tuned in to the latest and the greatest software that's being used in their programs, as well as any changes to the industry.
And that's huge, because it's not a textbook education. It's kind of like, you know, here's the skill, we're going to teach you in the craft. But here's the reality of the changing dynamics. You know, Kath, you mentioned about who knew when you started, you finished school many years ago, that it would evolve so much the way it has, right? And
absolutely.
That's where those deep industry ties. And, you know, some people might look at part-time professors and say, oh, they're part-time, what does that mean? To me, what that means is these are people that are in demand and are actually able to take time out of their schedule to mentor the next generation. I mean, that's what you want.
Without a doubt.
All right, so let's talk about that hands-on learning you were mentioning earlier. I love this idea of industry connections, and that comes to play especially as you go to explore future career opportunities or career paths. So talk to me a little bit about these industry connections, maybe some guest speakers. The guest speakers idea is really, I've always loved guest speakers.
Oh, we don't do guest speakers.
Oh, no, okay, no, next
we
slide.
We do guest artists.
So, you one up it. I like that.
Sorry about that.
That's great.
Without a doubt, that's part of the curriculum, is that we have guest artists come in. And that's really to appeal to all of the different artists that we're going to be working with. So we will look at who we have. If we have the majority of our class are singers, we're going to be bringing in guest artists that are singers and can really guide them. If we've got the majority are dancers, then we'll be bringing in dancers as well. That's over and above having a voice and a movement class. In our performance classes, we'll do that. We'll also have guest artists mentor throughout the production experience. So we will be doing live and digital theater right away, and you will determine your audience right away if you're uncomfortable with performing in front of strangers to begin with. We'll have you bring in your friends and family. If you prefer not to have friends and family, then we'll just do strangers as well. But that will be definitely part of the curriculum. We want to get you up on the boards or in front of, or puppeteering, or whatever you want to do. Absolutely, without a doubt, right away. The other connection with industry is that Chelsea is sitting here, and she is part of industry. Mm-hmm. Our curriculum is developed with industry. It can't move forward without industry. We all work with advisory committees, and we have people that are working in the industry alongside our guest artists and guest teachers, and really know where the industry is, and they help guide what we need to do as well.
That's phenomenal. I mean, I love that. All right, I'm going to remind everybody that if you have a question, and the questions are coming in, but if you have a question, don't be shy. Speaking of being shy, we had that conversation earlier. Tweet it at AC Design School, or go to your control panel. Just type it in there to Chelsea, to Kath, to Diane, and don't be shy. Be blunt. Ask any thought-provoking question you want. We're going to answer for you. We touched on this earlier, ladies, about what makes this program unique. Anything more you want to add to this? I mean, I just love the whole improvisation and artistry aspect, but what, anything else that we maybe didn't cover?
Well, I think what makes this program unique is that, you know, it's not limited to a specific kind of artist. I mean, the word artist is so broad and it can apply to so many things. And we want people that think they might, maybe they want to go into stand-up comedy, maybe they want to be a puppeteer, maybe they want to be an actress, maybe they want to be a singer. Anybody that's interested in any kind of art to come out for this program, because it will cover the basic skills that you need to pursue any of those industries. And, you know, speaking to, you know, someone, if, you know, if you're shy and thinking about doing this program, you should, because they are transferable skills. So no matter what industry you may end up in, they're skills that you can take with you anywhere.
That's a huge point. We had that discussion earlier, but I mean, what we didn't use was the word transferable, and that's, you nailed it. You nailed it right there. And both of you ladies, Kath and Chelsea, being comedians as well. I mean, how would this have helped you out when you're starting out down that track?
It would have been wonderful. ultimately, I would have had material already developed, and that's what this is about. It's about you're going to create your own material. You're going to write it so that when you walk out, you've got it. You've got it down pat. You don't have to stand up in front of an audience and go, oh, my goodness, I don't know what to say.
But you probably will do that anyway.
Of course.
Diane, you want to jump in here?
Chelsea answered what I was going to say, so she hit the nail on the head there.
And also, just to speak to that, you know, it's a one-year program. So I went to theater school for 4 years. So if we can speak to why I'm even interested in this program at all, is because if it was available, this would have been perfect for me when I was coming out of high school, certainly, because I jumped into a 4-year theater program, and I did a lot of self-discovery during that theater program. But the beautiful thing about this is, you know, it allows you to discover who you are as an artist before you jump into a 3, a 4 year program. And so, in my opinion, it will give you a leg up on either your continued education or your career focus.
All right. So one of the questions I'm sure you must get asked is, what's the difference between Algonquin College's theater arts program versus the performing arts program? So to clarify that, Diane, why don't you talk to us?
Okay, this is a question that I get a lot, especially at our open houses, because the programs sound similar. Theater arts, performing arts. And the main difference is theater arts program focuses on theater. Everything to do with theater, though, so that you're very clear. So you learn acting and directing, as well as production, lighting, set design, everything that goes into theater. The performing arts program is all performers. So every single kind of performance-related industry is covered. The difference, too, is that the theater arts program is a 2-year diploma. The performing arts program is a 1-year certificate. So you're spending 1 year, and as both Chelsea and Kath have indicated earlier, to discover which area or areas you want to go into. So it's all-encompassing. It's not just got one sole focus.
Fantastic. All right. Well, I got to tell you, I'm thrilled. I've heard everything that you ladies have had to say, and I'm jazzed, and I'm actually kind of jealous and envious that this opportunity wasn't made available to me. And I have a lot of laughter because I think we're all a little bit jealous. And so if you're listening to this and you say, I want to meet Chelsea and I want to have Kath teach me and I want to invest 1 year of my life in this, then have we got an answer for you. Just go to OntarioColleges.ca. You'll see the program. And Diane, I mean, we talk about grade 12 English. Are there any other requirements we need to know about as far as admission?
That's it.
Nice.
Well, and your grade 12 diploma, of course.
Grade 12 diploma. All right. Well, that seems reasonable. The admission offer is going out right now, right?
Correct. So if you were to apply today and you met all the admissions requirements, you would hear back very shortly, yes, you're into the program.
Okay. With that, if not only are you like rushing to apply imminently, but you also want to check out the facilities, well, we have this spring open house happening. Diane, talk to me a little bit about that.
The spring open house is on Saturday, April 5th, and the reason that we hold it on a Saturday is so that you can come in, bring your parents, friends. Often the parents want to talk to the teachers as well to find out if there are actually jobs out there, what career paths you can take, and you can come check us out. We're going to have tables set up in the gym, and then you will be able to take tours, go and see some of the classrooms or the labs or the studios, as Kath talked about, and we'd be happy to talk to you.
And as you're listening to this, you know, you mentioned parents, Diane, and you're considering this, and your parents maybe aren't able to share into tonight's webinar with you. When we send you the link, flip them this recording, because I'll tell you, there's some incredible content on here that I, as a parent, would be jazzed about. The idea for my child to be able to spend a year to go and explore, develop their skills, which are transferable no matter what career path they take, I am all over that. So I highly encourage that. Well, we told you it would take about a half an hour to get through the content, and then we get to Q&A. And guess what? I lied. It took us 35 minutes. I'm going to blame Diane for that for no other reason than she's an easy target. We're here now. We're at the Q&A time frame. Isn't that fantastic? So this is all the questions that we've been getting. You can ask them. I'm going to tell you, though, if we don't get to your question tonight or you are inspired and think of something after the fact, then what you can do is you can actually email Catherine or you can email Diane or you can call them, whatever you want to do. You'll see their information right there on the screen in front of you under Need More Information. We're going to leave this up there for a little bit. The other question I'll mention to you is if you want to go check out the program, you actually see the program's web address at the top of your screen. So we'll leave that there for you. There was a funny comment sent in, and you were speaking, ladies, about we have guests. We have guests from the industry. So we have singers. We have dancers. And somebody wants to know if you can actually have David Frost. And I think they may be reaching a little high. But, you know, if you can do that.
Well, I'll definitely email him. I don't expect it, but wouldn't that be incredible?
That would be
awesome. You never know.
You never know. I like that. There is no end to the possibilities. That's what this program is all about.
Absolutely.
Okay. If you have those questions, use your question function or go on Twitter. We're monitoring both. One of the questions they have for you, ladies, and maybe Diane, you're the best one to answer this one, is what is the cost of the program? So if you could give us some insights on that, that would be fantastic.
Okay, folks, so the cost for tuition is approximately $1,400 per semester, so that would be $1,400 times two for the year, $600 for your books and supplies, a one-time cost, and the other thing that you need to have is a laptop. All our programs at Algonquin are laptop mandatory, and you can find out on the program website what kind of laptop you need, what kind of functions it has to be able to do. And that cost is anywhere from $600 to $800. So that's what you're looking at. It's a pretty inexpensive first year to be able to go in and discover what it is that you would like to do.
Fantastic. Thank you, Diane. Now, so if there's more details on the cost you want to know, just send your questions in and we'll carry on. If we don't get you an answer tonight because you're asking really detailed questions, we will definitely get you an answer. So not to worry about that one. We have another question here is, are there any similarities between the music industry arts program and the performing arts program? Anybody want to hop in there?
I'm happy to take that one. And then maybe Diane might want to add on to that because she certainly knows a lot more about that program. The music industry arts program is a very technical program with a lot of technical equipment. The performing arts program is definitely geared to the performance angle more so than the music arts industry. The one similarity that we do have is that the person teaching music in the music industry arts program will be developing our music program and will most likely, I can't say that for sure, but hopefully might consider teaching it. So that would definitely be the one similarity.
Okay, and another similarity, just so that folks understand, the music industry arts program teaches you how to produce music. So mix music, record music, alter it. It does not teach you to be a musician or a performer. But having said that, most of the students who come into the program are musicians, and their goal is to break into the music industry, and they are learning this so that they can pay their way as they break into the industry and also have a really good understanding when they actually become recording artists.
Fantastic. Another question here. What type of writing skills and music skills, do you need when you get into industry? Kind of a broader question, maybe Chelsea.
Yeah, sure. I can take that one. Good ones is the answer to that one. The ability to, have good writing skills on a basic level and also on a creative level are extraordinarily important no matter what side you go into, whether it's performance or production. It's a reality of the biz, so you have to have, what I would consider to survive in this, the industry now is extraordinary communication skills. So as far as writing skills, you definitely need them. And what type of them, it depends on where you go and what you do. But if you can have a broad range of writing skills, that's great. So copywriting, script writing, editing skills are very important and certainly useful, even if you're only producing your own material. And in terms of music skills, I would say you need to have some sort of musicality. In terms of like in-depth music skills, I think you can kind of, you don't need in-depth music skills. You can weave in and out of certain, you know, depending on what type of task it is. But certainly a base in music is very important because most things in entertainment require a music component. So, I mean, speaking from experience, I've done everything from, you know, harmonies on radio jingles to, you know, musicals to, you know, writing bumpers or things like that, even editing small short bits of, you know, non-voiced music. So it's varied in range depending on the industry and the task, but certainly a basic music skills are important to have.
I would follow up on that and say that the reason why music is in the program, and some people were surprised that it was there, is because all performance is based on beats, on silence, on all the technical elements that you see in music. That's what performance is. There's a beat, then you move. That's what it's all about. So that's particularly why it's there. We actually want everyone in that course to perform music. Some may be very elementary beginner musicians, and we understand that. But we want you to stretch yourself, to push yourself a little bit, to explore other areas, to see whether or not that can be incorporated into your incredible artistry.
And I think there's two other definitions that are explored, and one is musicality and the other is rhythm.
Absolutely.
So you don't need to be in tune or but to understand those basic concepts are really important to even just
absolutely
everything.
You can't have comedy without rhythm and beats and ba-dum-bum.
Timing.
Timing so, is everything.
Yeah.
Like a part of it too though is just the environment they're gonna be immersed in, right? It is a creative environment and it's safe to explore and to feed off of each other. So it's all part and parcel.
There is no greater privilege for a teacher than to work with artists.
A little follow-on question, different person, but related. Will there be a course on songwriting?
There will not be a specific course on songwriting. However, if that's what you're interested in, then we'll definitely work with you and mentor you with that and ensure that you have the skills that you require for that.
All right. Another question here is, are there any age limits to joining the program?
Absolutely not. We hope to have an incredible mix of artists. I think that young people learn from people who are older, from the life skills they bring. Mm-hmm. And I'll tell you, I learn so much from the students that I have, whatever the age they are.
And even speaking to that, I went to college as a mature student. So I was actually working with a range of students. Some were younger, some were older. And, you know, Daryl, you were saying that there's a lot of content in this webinar that's great for parents, but it's also great for people who are already in industries. Maybe they're thinking of changing. Maybe they want to enhance this specific skill set. You know, it's great for anybody of, any age range.
Without a doubt. And I would say that performance is the one thing that will haunt you for the rest of your life. If you don't do it, you can be 40. I've had students that were 45 and came back and said, I've always wanted to do this. I was, you know, encouraged not to. There wouldn't be any jobs. I wouldn't get anywhere. And I'm 45 now at 50, and I want to come back. I want to live my life passionately.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, that's like, if you think you want to do it, you should do it because... Well, not only because of transferable skills, but because it is so much fun. Yeah. And, you know, any industry out there, anybody is going to say, you know, it's tough to get a job. It's hard to get a job. Well, if you know who you are and have the basic skills that you need. You can pave your way in any industry. I mean, that's maybe my personal belief, but paving your way in performance arts is as difficult as you make it. And so to get a basis in your education in the space, it will give you a leg up.
Some of the most successful students now that I taught 20 years ago, 25 years ago, weren't necessarily the ones that we thought were the most talented. They were the ones that were really persistent, that absolutely loved this and determined they were going to do this for the rest of their life. They have, and they're wonderful. I'm so proud of them.
Yeah, hard work, talent, and luck go a long way.
Diane, do you want to jump in there at all?
I was actually waiting for the next question.
Oh, the next question. There she goes. Well, we have several questions coming in here.
I'd like to talk about the one about if you move to another country. The question is, if we choose to move to another country to be a performer, how do we determine what type of visa we'll need? Would we be able to touch on that in the program? We have an incredible resource at the college called the International Center. And that center actually goes around to programs and can talk to students, because we have a lot of students in our 2 and 3 year programs that do a visa placement or a co-op, and they require a visa because we let students go anywhere to do that. You do not need to do that in this program, but what Kath can do as the coordinator is have someone come and talk to the class about the next steps. If that's what you want to do and you want to go to another country and perform, then we will walk you right through every step, tell you exactly what you need, how you prepare, how long it's going to take you to get your visa, and everything that you need to do.
Moreover, we have a class in first semester called Introduction to Global Performing Arts.
I just love how, I mean, you can really see as you're listening to this, folks, I mean, we know it's a new program, but you can see the impact of industry and of the faculty. They've lived it, and every question's coming up, you guys have got a great response to. That's incredible.
And we didn't just make it up either.
No, you didn't. These are all real.
Although we could.
These are all real questions coming in. What else we got here? Somebody's asking, they want to know if there's going to be an end of the year performance.
There will be an end of the week performance.
That's a lot of weeks.
That's a lot of weeks, without a doubt. In week 4, we'll be up and running, and you will be on the boards, as they say.
Okay. They want to know here, another question. What is the software or books or whatnot that they need to consider for the program? Diane, this is your expertise.
Some of the books we're still working on because, as Kath had said before, some of that will be determined by how many folks come that are interested in dance, in music, etc. What we're doing in this program is much more hands-on, so your books cost may not be that high. As I quoted you, but the software, the great thing about Algonquin is that as part of your tuition fee, the software is included for whatever program you apply to. So in this program, you would likely get the Adobe Master Collection, because that will teach you how to edit software and other things that you will need to do in the production phase of this program. So you don't have to worry about software whatsoever. That will all be loaded in the first week. You just bring your laptop in. We give you all the instructions on how to do that. And if there are any updates to that software while you're here, you get the updates as well.
That's huge.
Isn't having, it awesome?
having purchased that software, I'm thinking I'm just going to register just to get the software.
That's right.
I'll be going back to that slide on where to apply. I actually want to come back to you for a second, Chelsea, because one of the points you were making is about, you don't just have to be a student or a parent, but at any point in your career. And, when I listen to this, part of the reason it jazzes me is because, use me as an example, I am the world's biggest introvert. Diane, it's true, I am. Don't go there. And and I was a computer programmer for years, marketing. But as you see, when you do a webinar, it's no different than any other medium, that it is a performance art. You want to engage your audience. You want to entertain. You want to inform. And I just listen to the program, and I'm jazzed. I just want to come. I want to come and participate. Although you don't want any – I'm not – the musicality part skipped me entirely. So there we go. All right, so maybe
I would say that
go for it.
I'd say that artistry comes from the soul, and that There are so many great artists that are introverts, without a doubt. It's just something in them needs to come out and needs to be shared. I honestly believe that being an artist is a gift, and that gifts are meant to be shared.
And I think also, just to speak to that, and I mean, it's such an amazing, you know, place to start a program, is with that attitude that it needs, that, you know, the talent needs to be brought forward and brought out. Because being in, you know, the term entertainer or performer can be somewhat intimidating, mm-hmm. because, you know, you think of being in front of a crowd, or, you know, that's, you know, being exposed or being in the spotlight. And, you know, it's to come from a place where you're bringing it out of someone, is, it's not as scary as it seems. You know, it's a valuable life skill, basically. And then, you know, to apply that to performance, you know, certainly if someone's shy or an introvert, to know who you are and bring the talents that you have out is something very special about this program.
I think it's also a case, too, that the more you know, to your point, Chelsea, the more you get into the program and you establish that trust.
Yeah.
You blossom, right? Yeah. You go places you never thought you could go with your skill and your talent. I mean, that's, and it's hard to quantify that, but that is the reality of the journey. We'll take one more question here, just because we promise we get you out of here on time, and we will respect that. Last question on the plate tonight is, are there other performing arts programs at Algonquin, or maybe another post-secondary institution, that we should be evaluating or considering or recommending? Any thoughts?
Well, I'd go to Algonquin. It depends what kind of personality you are to determine what kind of post-secondary education you take. I mean, there are theater schools, there are university theater programs, there are there's musical theater programs, mm-hmm. there's, you know, music programs out there. Again, the beautiful thing about this program is that it's 1 year, and it will help you determine the best path for you as a performer, whether it's to go on to more education, or if you're ready to go in the industry and give it a shot. You know, it depends on the individual. So, you know, this program, because it's 1 year, it's a great intro to figure out, do I want to go into that 4-year conservatory program? Or maybe I just want to do 2 more years in theater. It will help you decide.
The other thing is, you will have industry folks as your teachers that will help guide you as well. They may see a little something in you that you don't see yourself, and they might pick up on that, and they can give you suggestions. They have connections. They are familiar with a lot of programs at colleges and universities and private schools, and they can help you with that decision.
Absolutely. I also want to give a big, huge shout-out to Ayana. Thank you very much
for being
here tonight.
All right. So, folks, if you enjoyed the program, and we did promise you it's being recorded, and it is, you'll see it again in your inbox in a couple of days. You can listen to an encore presentation. And, again, if you liked it tonight, please share it with your friends, your parents, anybody who can value and take advantage of this opportunity. They need to know about it. If you have more questions, give Catherine a call, give Diane a call, email them, whatever works for you. They'd love to talk to you and address any lingering questions, comments, concerns you may have. They're here for you. They're a phenomenal resource. Check out the program at the website address in the top right-hand corner of the screen there. Learn more. And, of course, apply. And, of course, after that, come to the Spring Open House, April 5th, 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. We'd love to see you. That's it, folks. We're done for the night. We are so glad that you took time out of your schedule to join us. It was a lot of fun. We hope you got as much value out of it as we had enjoyment delivering it. Special thanks to Chelsea and Kath, and, of course, to Diane. Take care, folks. Have a great night.